meet my mom. She looks very young. 48 years old now. She looks like she's in 30s or something. She's my mom. Her name is Madhavi, and today is her birthday. And thank you so much for all your wishes who have sent across. It really means a lot to us. Thank you.
Thank you.
So apparently she loves soya nugget ka manchuria. So this is that. And making whatever she loves to eat. So this is one of it. I'm gonna show you the brunch today. We didn't have a breakfast as such. So you saw the soya, which is almost done in the kitchen. So today I have asked her what she want to eat, and I am preparing all those things which she actually like it. I'm gonna show you the other brunch recipes also. We didn't have breakfast as such, we just had coffee, and we are just gonna do brunch today. We are skipping the breakfast and lunch. I'm gonna show you what we are having for brunch now. As you saw, these are the soya nuggets, and this is tomato rice. There is a story behind tomato rice on birthdays. I'll tell you after this clip. And we have homemade carrot halwa, gajar ka halwa, and these three are yummy. There is a story behind the tomato rice on birthdays. Ever since she started making tomato rice, we remember that she used to ask us what we want for a birthday, for breakfast, lunch, or whatever it might be. We used to always say we want tomato rice, me and my brother. Birthdays is equal to tomato rice. It is like that. So I actually don't know how to prepare that. So I asked her how to make it and made it on her birthday, which is very nostalgic feeling. I can't tell you how it feels, but it really feels weird as well as very happy, because I'm actually preparing this for my mom, and it really means a lot to me. So this is my thali. Look at everything, guys. Isn't it looking yummy? I'm super duper hungry right now because I didn't have anything from morning. I woke up at around 6:20 and I made breakfast, the tomato rice for Rakshit. He went to office almost around 8 o'clock. So after that I was cooking carrot halwa and soya nuggets. Look at the soya nuggets, the texture of it, the manchurian, and the good part is I haven't deep fried these ones. I just fried it with couple of spoons of oil. The process is kind of different but similar, but I don't usually deep fry anything, guys. I kind of avoid deep frying because oil wastage, and we cannot have so much oil in our diet. So I kind of avoid deep frying usually. And this is a carrot gajar ka halwa, carrot halwa. So I made it without khoya or khoa. I used only milk, and I have cooked it for almost 2.5 hours and made this one. This really really tastes yummy, and it is like real authentic carrot halwa. And the tomato rice is that good old tomato rice which my mom used to make when I was a kid for a lunchbox. So it really feels nostalgic. My mom really loves these soya nuggets. I have a memory of having soya and bread pieces in a palau, vegetable palau. But apart from that, I haven't tried this kind of recipe. After marriage, I came here and I saw some recipe online. So I thought of recreating it, but I didn't like that way. So I made my way of the soya nugget manchurian. She really loves it a lot. we have a memory in lockdown. We have sleep issues, right? If we feel hungry after 12 o'clock or something, this is the go-to snack. We eat a lot. It is good for health also. It doesn't have fat and all carbohydrates, so it is good because we are eating post 12, which is very unhealthy. But eating a protein is kind of okay, that is what I think. So I boil it for almost 10 minutes, then I cook it for a couple of minutes with other sauces and all. So it really, really tastes amazing. If you want any of these recipes, let me know in the comment section below. I'll definitely do it for you guys. And now let me enjoy my lunch and cheers. This is the setup which I'm going for. I have added a couple of fairy lights to this portrait, and this is gonna be the background. And here we are actually arranging the cake. You will see the video anyway, but this is the look which I'm going for. And the kurta is from Myntra. So this is very, very like basic look. I haven't added anything on my face, just a compact powder and moisturizer, and that's it. Kajal and eyeliner and a lipstick. So this is the look, and my mom and dad are inside the room. I just left them there and asked them not to come here. So this is the setup, and the party is gonna start right now. And you know what, my mom has no idea about them. So for the dinner, we have decided to make this chaat, which is very famous in Bangalore. This is called Bangalore Masala Puri, which is yummy. So I have added couple of spices to the oil and added onion, roughly chopped onion. Then I'm gonna add ginger garlic paste and chilies to that and cook it for a couple of minutes. Once it becomes little mushy, I'm gonna add roughly chopped tomatoes. I have taken almost 4 tomatoes and I have roughly chopped, and I'm gonna add it to this. Now I'm gonna add a little bit of salt to that, which kind of makes it mushy. Once it's all cooked, I'm gonna switch off the flame and keep it aside till it rests, and then I'm gonna blend it in the blender. Before starting this process, I have cooked the aloo and green peas, which are very necessary for any chaat recipes. I have let it sit for almost 5 sitees and it's cooked completely. I'm gonna take the aloo out and mash it separately and mash green peas separately. Here I just want a creamy texture of the peas with the peas texture also. So I have taken a little bit in the blender jar and I have blended and added to the mashed peas. This kind of gives the creamy texture, but also let the texture of the peas be there. I'm making sense here. In the blender jar, I have taken the tomato onion cooked mixture and also added some green peas to this to kind of get the texture, and added coriander. You can add pudina also, it really gives it the yumminess, but I didn't have pudina, so I didn't add it. Now to the same pan, I'm taking a little bit of oil and adding chili powder, coriander powder, jeera powder, some chaat masala, garam masala and amchur powder, and I let it cook for a couple of minutes and then add the mixed mixture to this and cook it for some more time. Look at it, it is so creamy and very tempting. And now I'm gonna add the mashed potatoes and mashed green peas to this and stir it for a couple of minutes and let it cook for a couple of minutes. Once it feels everything is completely mixed, I'm gonna put it into sim and put the lid on and let it cook for almost 20 minutes. After that, it's done. This is how we serve masala puri. I have crushed couple of puris and added the mixture and added onion, tomatoes and the bale and a little bit of coriander. You can add a little bit of amchur powder or chaat masala also. It really tastes yummy. Okay, it's the editing day. I'm actually editing this vlog and I have noticed that I haven't ended the vlog, so I'm doing it right now. I really hope that you liked watching this vlog. It was a random vlog. I just wanted to document the celebrations in quarantine, lockdown or pandemic, whatever it might be. I really tried my best to make her day special. I really tried my best to celebrate this day. I don't know whether I have done it completely or not, but I'm very happy from inside that I have done something or other in this pandemic, because nobody, we cannot go out, and it was really tough to get that cake also, so it is okay. So yeah, that is it for today's video. I really hope that you liked watching this video, and I have planned a whole lot of a bunch of videos for this month, July. Please stay tuned and please subscribe to my channel, and mostly I'm planning to upload every video around 11 o'clock or 10 o'clock. I'll let you people know once the first video is uploaded, that is this video is uploaded. You'll get to know the timings and all. So every day I'm gonna come up and put a video at that particular time. I'm really trying hard to make videos and having a schedule of particular schedule for my videos. So I'm really hoping that I should do this. And thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you liked it, and let me know your thoughts about this video in the comment section below, and let me know what you would like to watch next, what type of videos you want to watch. Obviously I'm filming vlogs also, and I'm filming some other different videos also, which usually matches my profile, I mean matches my YouTube channel. And there are styling videos which are coming up. I know many of you people have subscribed for curvy styling tips. I know that. I'm actually planning some of the videos for that also. Please stay tuned, guys. I really hope that you like all of the videos which are coming up in your way. And yeah, that is it for today's video. I really hope that you like it. Please give it a like and subscribe. And yeah, see you in another video. Until then, take good care of yourself and keep loving. Mwah. Bye.